गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू करा इंग्लिश स्कूल। आई होप यू ऑल मस्ट बी फाइन डियर। यू नो दैट दिस इज योर क्लास थर्ड एन सी आर टी ईवीएस बुक लुकिंग अराउंड एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड द चैप्टर नंबर 23 अ ब्यूटिफुल क्लोथ। एंड यू नो डियर स्टूडेंट्स दैट इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द क्लोथ्स एंड फाइबर्स। एंड इफ वी ऑल क्लोथ्स वी आर वियर द क्लोथ्स टू कवर अवर बॉडी एंड टू प्रोटेक्ट अस फ्रॉम हीट, कोल्ड, विंड, रेन एंड इंसेक्ट बाइट। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एट the end of the of this lesson you will be able to identify the texture of clothes, you will be able to analyze the role of weather and occasion in clothing choice, you will be able to know what natural and man-made fibers are. So dear students, this is a picture and the clothes we wear the clothes to protect us from heat, to protect us from cold, from wind, from rain and insect bite. You know that the role of the seasons. So you know that during winter season we wear the clothes made of wool and silk. As in the picture you are watching that this is a boy who is wearing the woolen clothes. There is a muffler in his neck, there is a cap on his head. So this type of clothes we wear in winter, and the clothes we wear in winter that is made of wool and silk. During winter season there is in Kashmir there is so much snow falling, that is why the people of there try to wear the woolen clothes to protect them from cold weather. There is summer season. During summer season everyone want to wear the light cotton clothes that keep them cool, and that is very comfortable. The cotton clothes are very comfortable during summer season, and the cotton clothes absorb the heat and sweat. During rainy season we wear the rain suit and the gum boots. The gum boots are made of rubber, and also we have to take the umbrella to protect us from the rain. You know that we get the clothes or fibers from two sources. There are two sources. The first is natural and the second is man-made. The fibers are two types, natural fibers and man-made fibers. So first of all, natural fibers we get from plant and animal. Natural fibers such as cotton and jute are obtained from plant. Then in natural fiber, the silk and wool are obtained from animal. The cotton is obtained from cotton plant and the jute is obtained from jute plant. In natural fibers, the wool is obtained from sheep and the silk is obtained from silkworm. The next is man-made fibers. As you are watching here, the fibers that are produced by humans are called man-made fibers. The man-made fibers are polyester, the rayon, nylon, etc. The fibers that are produced by humans are called the man-made fibers. The tent is made of man-made fibers. Tents are made of special cloth called tarpaulin. This cloth is very thick and that is waterproof. That is why the tent are made of this cloth. Now we start the chapter, A Beautiful Cloth. Sajida's sister gave her a very beautiful dupatta. The dupatta had beautiful embroidery and small mirror stuck on it. After finishing dinner, Sajida tried to wear the dupatta in different ways. Soon she got tired playing with dupatta and fell asleep wearing it. She was thinking about the dupatta even in her dream. How would such a beautiful dupatta have been made? So there is a girl whose name is Sajida. Her sister gave her a very beautiful dupatta. As you are watching, there is so much beautiful embroidery is on the dupatta. These are the mirrors that are stuck on this dupatta. So her sister gave her a beautiful dupatta, and she, after taking her dinner, Sajida tried to wear her dupatta in different ways, but soon she got tired and fell asleep wearing her dupatta, as you are watching in the picture. And she was very impressed, and the dupatta was so beautiful and lovely that she was thinking about her, about the dupatta, even in her dream too. And she was thinking, how would such a beautiful dupatta have been made? So some questions are there. How do you think Sajida's dupatta was made? So you can answer that the dupatta had very beautiful embroidery and small mirrors was stuck on it. Question number 2. Take a dupatta or a long piece of unstitched cloth, drape it in different ways. In how many ways could you wear it? So the answer is, the dupatta can be used in different ways, like with salwar kameez and lehenga, and with the western wears as stole and scarf. Question number 3. Did anyone wear it like a lungi or use it as turban? In what other ways was the cloth worn? So you can answer, yes, the man wear it as lungi and turban, and the ladies also use it as I have been told you in your answer number 2. Look at any 6 garment at home. What differences do you find in their texture, their color and design? Texture means when you touch something, or when you touch any clothes, then you feel something hard or soft, you feel something soft. So this is the mean of texture. So the answer is, yes, the garment is different according to the texture, color and design. In the according to the texture, the garment is rough and smooth according to the texture. It is different in color. The color can be dull and bright. It is different in design, that can be simple and complex. Look at the thick cloth or a sack carefully. Can you see thread running along this length and breadth? And you will see the pattern too. So the answer is, yes, I can see the thread running along the length and breadth of the cloth, and I also noticed a similar pattern when I saw different pieces of clothes. So this is the first part of the chapter. I hope you like it, because I have made you understand how and when the clothes are wear, and which type of clothes are wear in which type of season. So dear students, listen carefully and try to understand. We will meet in the next part of the chapter. Till then, have a nice day.